Hello everybody, Nintendo Capricorn here, and welcome back to Let's Play Donkey Kong Country 3. How's everybody doing? We are on what appears to be some kind of a snow level. Oh yeah, I played this level, what the hell? Why don't I remember this? Well, I do remember this now that I've seen it, yeah. But, it did just come to mind earlier. Just playing so many games lately. Oh, well, they don't look like tampons in this game, they look like dogs. You youth league dogs don't stand a chance, no. I'm gonna bounce on your head. I'm gonna make you go away. I'm gonna bounce on your head. Today is, February 6th. Yeah, I made my second day. You know, I never celebrated January 27th this year. It's a 20-year anniversary of my tapes, and I never celebrated it. I'm like, what? I like that music for some reason. It's just so urgent. No! I died! Excuse me. Dang, man, you guys are turning around. Gotta be more careful. Man, I am so full right now. All I had was like three bowls of chicken and rice, and they were like an hour apart each. But I guess eating stuff too close together can be bad. No, I wasn't trying to hit you with it, jeez. Oh, well, thanks for respawning. Little steel barrel of mine. Wait, can I hit the wall with that? No. Why is that guy even there? No, I want the barrel. I want to see if I need it for anything. No, stop. That's probably why he's there. He's an obstacle to make you lose the barrel. Okay, well, let's find out if we can do something with this. I don't want to jump down there. Or there. Man, this is like that. Oh! Boom! I bet there was a secret area right there, too. Right in the wall. Right in the water. What are you doing back there? What is that? Oh, that's a... I thought it was in the background, like behind the trees. I'm like, jeez. Ugh. This is the joy of playing a game blind. Even though I'm not blind yet, I don't remember this stuff that well. It's like, you know, you play a level one time, you kind of get a... You only get a fleeting glimpse of a memory as to what happened in that level, or, you know, whatever. Whoo! The fanfare when you beat a level sometimes, it sounds so lackadaisical. Like, even in the second game, it was lingering towards that. And I'm not complaining or anything, it's just weird, that's all. Okay. Man, it's like that game Tabuto. That Flash game, I think it's Tabuto. Okay, this is the level where the elephant gets scared by the mice, I remember that. Because I couldn't figure out what was scaring him, I was like, wait now, not those are rats. I thought it was the light that was scaring him at first. Eventually, I figured it out. I was like, why does he keep doing that? I was like, dude. Oh, okay, I see that, I see that Radley has taken an evil form in this game. As far as I know, the elephant can't, like, bash into walls or anything. But, kill that. Maybe those are the mice that scare him, because I... Bananas here. Yeah, we can sneak under. Let me see if these really are... Okay. I'm not sure yet, but... Because he didn't seem to get scared of those other ones earlier. But he will get scared, and he'll start running on you, and you gotta watch out, because... Oh! There he goes. Wait, no. I just got hit by that one. Checkpoint! A bee. And a barrel. Say goodbye to the rat. The rat-ily. Yay! Got my second hit. Alright. Wait, I want this. I just get a feeling. I bet if I get on this elevator and ride it up and jump to the left, there's something there. Let's find out. No! Okay, well... That was a smart place to look. Don't tell me that wasn't a smart place to look. Okay, that bee is invisible, but... Or invincible. Indestructible. Whatever. Oh, okay. Well, thank goodness the elevator stops me instead of just carrying you into him. Like it would have done before. Whoa! Jeez. This is kind of scary. But once again, we're starting to see a... Oh, I see. I think it's only when the rats are in the light. That's when he gets scared. So if you just... Yeah, but see, even if you're not, like... Even if you're, like, way above him, he'll start running the other way. And just go totally out of control. So I think you have to... I think you actually have to kill him with a barrel, which I don't have because I destroyed and I just lost... Oh, my God. There you go, first death of the game, what do you know? this is going to happen when you don't know what you're doing, apparently. That's okay, I wanted the barrel to respawn anyway. Oh, I don't start with two hits? I think it's hilarious you can hear a chimp in there. You know, chimping. And yet, you know, there is no chimp when you open the barrel. It's just a second hit for whatever animal you're controlling. Yet it still makes the chimp sound as if there were a chimp in there. Now I see why these guys jump so high. Okay, it does respawn. Great. You're supposed to run under them. You're supposed to throw the barrel at the mouse. There, now we can progress. Yay! Don't worry, Mr. Elephie, I'll take care of you. Whoa! How did that happen? Did I just suck that? I did! I didn't know he could do that! That is so cool! I wonder if I'm gonna have to be doing that in the future. I shudder to think. Oh no! Oh dear me, I wanna stomp that one, but I'm afraid we're gonna need to go back and get another barrel and sneak it under the bee. And don't hit the bee with it. These bees are getting more and more mechanical. Where do they get these bees from? Mother 3? Did the pig masks make these? Good lord. Another one. More. I think you have to wait till they're out of the light and then make a run for it. There we go. Hey, no more elephant. I don't know why I always want to say elephant. Because I read this joke when I was a kid. I can't remember if it was a joke or what it was. That's swanky sideshow here. But the answer had something to do with the telephone. There's something about a telephone and an elephant, and the word telefee, telefee, was in the answer to the riddle. So hell if I can remember what it is. Anyway. A more funny joke that I remember from my childhood was, what do you get when you cross an elephant with peanut butter? You get either peanut butter that never forgets, or an elephant that sticks to the roof of your mouth. I hear a chimp calling for help. Do I need to... Oh, I guess so. Okay. Oh, guess what, guys? We're the boss. We're the boss, and this is what you gotta do. You gotta basically toss the beetles into his mouth, and don't stomp the beetles. You're supposed to stomp them once, yeah, and then just toss them in and hope they go in. It's really kind of a burp, and he burps. Gets knocked back a little bit. This is one of those fights where if you let him chase you off to the end, he'll knock you off the side. So it's kind of like that one fight in Yoshi's Island against Sluggish... Mr. Sluggy the Unshaven, or whatever he's called. It's like that fight, actually, so you just have to push... Except there's no pushing him back. It's actually more like the Crocomire in Super Metroid, actually. Anyway, that was actually a lot easier this time. I had a little trouble with that last time, but... couldn't possibly get any easier. Finish this world, the cannon... travels you back out, and now you can just travel to the next world, which is Crimwood Forest, or you could go out and explore some more. But, that's gonna be a really short video if I do that. I don't think there really is anything else I can do out here, though. Like, I may have gathered enough coins to, like, buy something, maybe? I don't know. No, you can't actually go over the rocks with a boat. And you can't hold down B to go fa-ha. Well, thanks, Funky, for not charging me anything, or maybe you did charge me something, and I just don't remember. Funky's been working out. Something. Well, check out the butt on that one. Yeah, he must work out. Hello, guy, how are you doing? What will it be on this fine day, Kong? Where's the shell from? Patrick Cullen is online. Can we exit? Can I get that to disappear? I can't see the words, because Patrick Cullen is online. It's covering it up! What? Would you like to purchase this fine specimen? I didn't see what it said. But I'll take it. Here's the deal. I hope you're very happy together. Good morning. What would you like to know? So who owns the castle? Well, I ventured up there once, but if you want to know what I discovered, it'll cost you 2 coins. I'm saving for Swankies. Are you sure? Some cheeky lad called Link... Wait, what? Link was in just last week. He didn't have enough coins, and he seemed such a nice fellow that I agreed to accept 500 rupees instead. After that, he left, muttering about my shells being the wrong shape or something. What was he doing, trying to wipe his butt with them? It's 500 rupees, what did you give him, the Zora's flippers? After that, he left, oh. Is that a mirror? Yes, but it's no ordinary one, though. It was Cranky's great-grandfather's. I can't let it go for less than 50 coins. Holy mackerel. Yes, please. I'll take it. Hold on there, young Kongs. I'm afraid you don't have enough. Whatever. Well, that was fun. So I got a seashell, but I'm not sure what it does. I'll be able to see when I go back and edit the video, so don't worry. I'll know then. By the time this video goes up, I'll know. But in the meanwhile, I'm not going to be able to really know what... Freak out. Spare parts for my boats are what it's all about. Gotta go calm. Surf's up. I'm guessing that the seashell might actually be a spare part for the boat to enable you to go to other areas or something. I don't know. I guess we'll find out as we go along. That's the fun of it, though, really. Barrel shield bust up. This does not look promising at all. I mean, this does not bode well. Oh, no! You know what? I actually did play a little bit of this level 2. And I got so intimidated that that's why I stopped, was because of this level. So that's why I've only seen the first world. Man, he's fast. Well, at least it's not like Battletoads, where you go off the bottom of the screen and you die, like in the Revolution. Oh, barrel shield. I see what you mean. See, something there was actually supposed to hit me, I think, but occasionally it doesn't hit you because you're protected somehow by a barrel shield. Yeah, by the barrel shield right there. It's just floating there in the air. Man, this looks like just a timing puzzle here. Whoa! I thought I was behind it, but I guess not. Boo. Can I get another chimp? Can I get my other chimp back? This is like, I'm recording these videos, these first two, at the same time, so I don't really... So I'm still trying to remember, like, what that guy's name is. Is it Winky? Winky, jeez. I'm gonna feel so stupid, because I'm telling you. Does, I didn't know if he went off the edge or not. Well, there's a checkpoint. I don't think I reached the checkpoint last time. Hey, my chimp! Oh no, you gotta follow the barrel up? That's gonna be real... I'm just gonna go. Yeah, that's gonna be... tricky. If I ever have to do that again. Which I guess I will if I get knocked back to the checkpoint. I keep thinking these barrels in the background are, like, usable. Holy crap, that's really hard, because you're, like, bigger than the barrel is. I'm not sure where to hide, and, maybe just protect my head, I guess. Because it doesn't matter too much if it hits your feet. You know what, I should just call this guy Derpy Kong. Because he looks kind of derpy, right? That'll be, like, my adoptive name for him. I'm pretty sure whatever it is, it probably starts with a D, because all the other ones start with a D. But if that's the case, then I feel even stupider, because it should be even that much more obvious. No, you hit my head, man. I'm not supposed to let you hit me in the head. Okay, there's no barrel shield on this one, so... Do a barrel shield! Yeah, when there's a barrel shield, apparently the pattern is kind of irregular. Okay. Oh, I want my chimp! I want the chimp! Yeah, are we almost done here? Holy crap. This is scary. It's scaring me. Oh, what is that? It's like a hand reaching out of the toilet. Oh, he's friendly. Alright, thank you. Hey, I got a one-up for that. I got 15 lives! And I've never even played this before. Well, I have once. But still. The first world, I mean. I know I've said that like a million times. I just want to make sure everybody's, like, paying attention and all. Let's get on the other side of the rope here. Maybe that'll help, too. That's probably what I was doing wrong, actually, before. Just notice how they're putting the bananas, like, to the left and right of it. I think they're trying to say something there. Oh, I just blew up the side of the tree, but let me see what's over here first. Or is this... That's the end of the level. Okay, let's go see what's over here, then. First we go right, then left, then right, then left, then... What?! No, just kidding. Making a Battletoads reference there. Why would I... Oh, wait, there's a hole up there. Huh? Oh, no, wait, come back. I want to do that again. I stopped herring too soon. But it was definitely not a red herring. Boshi barrel! Oh, that is awesome, yeah. Grab 15 bananas! Can you do it? Let's find out. No! Oh, dear me. Oh, I see, you gotta grab the green ones, okay. Oh, I see, it keeps you on the same screen. Okay. Well, this is easy. on the right side first, and then go up and worry about whether or not we need to go up or down. I assume if I get hit, it's all over, so... No, 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 we have three left. Come on, come on, come on. There you go. Yeah! Wait, they're not gonna stop- Ah! Oh! Oh, I just barely got it! I just barely got it! Oh, yeah, that was fun. It's officially blind from here on out, folks. So next time on Donkey Kong Country 2, let the real pain begin, Danny boy. See you guys later.